from the studios of Amateur Radio Video News. That's actually just my ham shack. This is Ham Radio Now, the first of our programs from the ARRL and TAPR 2013 Digital Communications Conference held in Seattle back in September. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. And this program is going to be the introductory session from Friday morning that Steve Bible conducted. It'll help give you a feel for what the Digital Communications Conference is all about, the facilities and the way things are set up. It'll give you an idea of what it's like to actually be there. No technical presentation in this one. And if you recall from the Kickstarter, these programs were sponsored by, well, first of all, by you. About 115 of you made individual contributions to the Kickstarter that filled out about half of the funding that got me out to Seattle. And the other half was by three primary, what I'll call corporate underwriters. They are TAPR itself, Flex Radio Systems, and Elecraft. And in the unlikely event that you're not familiar with TAPR, let me tell you that they are a membership organization dedicated to all things digital in amateur radio. They started out with packet in the early 1980s, and they've grown from there. So if you do digital, you probably want to join TAPR. So stop by their website at TAPR, that's TAPR.org. The next one is Flex Radio Systems. They're featuring the new 6000 series of software-defined radios. That's the 6500 and 6700 transceivers and the 6700R receiver. These radios digitize RF pretty much right at the antenna connector, and they do just about everything else in software, so they can do some amazing things with really super high specs, and you can get details on them from flexradio.com. And finally, by Elecraft. Elecraft has a growing line of products. They're anchored by the K3 and KX3 transceivers, which cover HF plus 6 meters, and they have optional 2-meter transverters that fit right inside. They're available as kits or fully assembled. The Elecraft line also includes a few more transceivers, like the K2, K1, KX1, the amplifiers, antenna tuners, and accessories. You find them all on the web at elecraft.com. And in the Kickstarter, I promised each of the big underwriters a couple of minutes of detail, sort of a commercial, I guess. I'll rotate them among the various programs, so you'll just see one in each program. And since this is the introductory session, let me get started with TAPR itself. TAPR is dedicated to advancing the amateur radio art. They're focused on digital communications in all its forms. And if you're interested in anything digital in amateur radio, you will find like-minded hams to both support and challenge you in TAPR. There are special interest groups and a bunch of specialty mailing lists to keep you in touch with hams who share your niche. You'll also find kits to help you get started building stuff. You can start with simple projects and work your way up to a full high-performance software-defined transceiver. But you need to know that many of the kits are done as limited production runs just to get projects off the ground. Then TAPR members and their designers move on to the next project. So if something piques your interest, don't wait too long. TAPR sponsors the DCC, of course, along with the ARRL, and they host forums at some of the larger ham fests throughout the year. You can expect a big presence at Dayton with a booth, a forum, and a dinner. They publish their quarterly newsletter, the Packet Status Register. And I love that they've kept the name Packet in that. Yes, Packet is still around and TAPR keeps their hand in it. But like TAPR itself, the Packet Status Register is now all things digital in amateur radio. Membership in TAPR is $25 a year. That'll get you a discount on some of the kits. And of course, I'm going to point you to their website, TAPR, TAPR.org for more. And now let's head on down to Seattle for that introductory session as TAPR President Steve Bible N7HPR gets things off to a rousing start, or tries to wake everyone up.
And we're live now for the 2013 DCC. There you go. All right, good morning, everybody. My name's Steve Bible, N7HPR. Welcome. And we're glad to have you here. It looks like we still got a couple of chairs. There's still some folks checking in. Yep, there's people over here wanting to have neighbors, all right? The warm and cozy. There's still a few people checking in on the outside, but of course what we want to do is try to stay on schedule here and get to the talks, but we want to take a few minutes this morning to welcome you and give a few introductions. Make sure that the important things are announced, like for example, the bathrooms are out the door to the right. Well, you guys are not awake this morning. That was to be funny, okay? All right, I gotta work on that. I gotta work on that.
Keep your day job.
I shall do that. All right, so let me get my notes here. I'd like to introduce Jim Pace, K7CEX. He is the Northwest Vice Director. Does anybody recognize him? All right, come on up, Jim.
Thank you very much, Steve. Well, welcome, and we're on behalf of the ARRL and the Northwestern Division. We're excited about this conference. It's not something that happens here that often, and so we hope you're as enthused about it as we are. I'll be around throughout the weekend. If you have any questions about ARRL, if you have any issues you'd like me to take back to Newington, I'd be happy to do that as well. Just to let you know, if you're part of the Northwestern Division, one of my projects this year and going into next year is raising funds for our Northwest Scholarship Fund. You've probably seen some... Okay, now who's old enough to remember what that sound was? Froggy. That's even older than the Choose Heart. Okay. Anyhow, the Northwest Division Scholarship Fund is set up to provide help to deserving students who are going into electronics or any sciences and medicine and things like that. So we're trying to raise funds for that. So you'll see some advertising throughout this next year. The second thing is one of my pet projects, and those of you that know me know I'm very keen on Teachers Institute. Teachers Institute, if you don't know about it, is an ARRL program to send junior high and senior high teachers to training every year to give them interested and let them bring RF technology back to the classroom so that we can have more conferences like this as students grow up. How many of you actually got involved in ham radio because of maybe a high school program? Okay, a few. Boy, that bombed like your joke. This is a tough room, man.
It is. It's a tough crowd. Yes.
Anyhow, Teachers Institute, we pay all of their expenses, transportation, everything, to get them into a program where they can learn about RF technology and bring that back to the classrooms. I think it's a great program. If you want to know more, talk to me about it, and we'll see if we can get, and maybe some of you are in that teaching category. There are two levels of Teachers Institute. One is a basic level, and the second one is a more advanced level, and it deals with space technology and futuristic kind of things. So tell me, how many of you are actually not from the Seattle area? Oh, good. Whole bunch of you. That's great. I want to make two points for you, mostly. There is a rumor going around that we pipe noise into our sports stadium. So I want you to take that information back to where you come from and tell people that that is just not true. We don't pipe extra sound into the sports stadium. You see, in the Northwest, the natural voice box control goes up to 12. All right, hey, we're doing good here. And then the final thing is, if you're enjoy the city, there's so much to do, but one caution. My lady friend and I came up for a baseball game a little while back, and our tradition is we come up, then we go to dinner, and then we go to the game. I left the tickets in the car. And she asked me about them. I said, you know, they're in the car. We'll have to go back to the car to get him. And sure enough, we got back to the car. The front window had been broken, and there were four more tickets there. Okay.
Larry, can you follow him and improve upon that, I shall say? Larry Wolfgang from headquarters?
Yeah, I'm left with some tough acts to follow, right? Well, I'd like to welcome you to DCC on behalf of ARRL headquarters staff. And thank you for coming out. I understand that we've set a record for pre-registrations, and there was some indication that there were a few first-time attendees. Who was a first-time attendee at a DCC? Look at that. That's a lot of hands. Fantastic. Well, be prepared to be wowed, and be prepared for a fantastic weekend. I'm sure you're really going to enjoy it. This is our 32nd year of DCC. And the fact that we've got such a high attendance this year, I think, is a good indication that DCC is going strong, we're growing, and it's a great program. So we hope to see all of you first-time attendees, along with all the returners, for many years to come. DCC is always a fantastic program. Ulterior motives, well, most of you know, or some of you know, that I'm the editor of QEX. Anybody here not a QEX reader? A couple, okay. You all have to see me sometime during the weekend to find out about QEX. The rest of you, I'm always anxious to hear your ideas for articles and projects, your ideas for improvements, and just generally talk about the magazine. So I'm around all weekend. Most of the time I'm probably in here looking, you know, trying to learn something, but as I'm wandering around, please talk to me. I look forward to talking to many of you. Thanks for coming out to DCC.
And thank you, Larry. When the DCC alternates from city to city to city, and what really draws the DCC to a city is an active local host. I'd like to introduce Steve Stroh, whom probably many of you know, and the Microhams have been very instrumental in helping bring the DCC to Seattle. So Steve, please come up and tell us a little bit about Microhams and all the great work you guys have done.
Well, on behalf of Microhams and a number of other groups, I'd like to welcome you to Seattle. And I take minor issue with Steve and Larry's characterization of the DCC is growing. I think it's because they decided to put the DCC in Seattle this year. And the DCC comes around apparently once every 17 years. We last had it here.
Has it been that long?
Yes.
Jeez.
Well, my daughter was 3, and now she's 20. Not coincidentally, my wife and I hosted DCC in 1996 here in Seattle, a few miles down the road. That hotel doesn't exist anymore, but this is a nicer venue, believe me. One of the things I'm proudest about bringing the DCC here to Seattle is that this is really fertile ground for digital communications. And I'm just going to run through a quick list. Nearest and dearest to my heart is the group of crazies that has called themselves at various times WetNet, Puget Sound Amateur Radio TCPIP Group, a mouthful, which got credit in the 1996 DCC. We also have a pretty active mailing list called, which you might know it better as SEATCP. But along with them is groups like NWAPRS, NWMesh, HamWAN, And this, of course, is the headquarters area for ICOM America, the creator of D-Star. And a new entrant, we hope, called NW Digital Radio. You will hear a lot about them in the coming months and years. And Microhams is a group of hams associated in some way with Microsoft, although it is not an official Microsoft club. It's the one that I choose to affiliate with. They're doing the most interesting things, in my opinion, in the local area. They're pretty digitally focused and, to a person, very tech savvy. So I have a lot of fun with them, and they stepped up, and some of the heavy lifting is being done by MicroHymns members. So if you see them, talk to them, thank them for being willing. And last but not least, by any stretch of the imagination, I'd like to thank my wife, Tina, KD7WSF, who is truly the brains of the outfit here. She's responsible for this beautiful venue and a lot of the negotiation that made it possible to bring the DCC to the Seattle area this year. So if you'd like to have them come back, tell Steve. It's due to come back to the West Coast in 3 years or so.
Well, and thank you, Steve. So Steve, say thank you to Tina. Big, big thank you to Tina. Kenny Richards, Kenny? Not here yet.
Dave's not here.
Phil? Phil's right here. He's been a huge help. Phil's volunteered to take a hand in setting up the presentations here. So for those of you who are presentation people, please get with Phil, give him your presentation. Also want to give a big thanks to Gary Pierce. Gary doing all of the video recording. He's back up there in the booth. A really exciting thing is Gary, of course, you know, is kind of this struggling artist, and it was really fantastic to see the Kickstarter program that he put together and then was immensely successful on that. I thought what was really, really heartwarming was reading through the comments. And if you get a chance, go to Gary's Kickstarter and just go to the comments section and just see all of the well wishes and the praises that are going there. And I was just like, wow, the DCC really is reaching further than just the conference room that we're in here right at the moment. And people felt that there was value in that, so then they pledged monies in order to, so that they can get to see the presentations, even though they couldn't be here. So in a big part, thanks to Gary's Kickstarter, and a big part, thanks to all of you for, you know, this is where your money goes for your registration fee, for this building, you know, for the room, for the food, and all of that. So please give us feedback as to the venue and how it works out for you, if the chairs are comfortable enough for you. Next year, we'll bring a massage therapist in. But let us know. Give us feedback on how we can make the DCC better each year. And as Steve mentioned, so what we do is we try to rotate East Midwest. So this is our West Coast venue for this year, and we're looking at heading back east or mid, and we're actively negotiating in the Austin area right now. So I don't want to make it official yet until we actually sign a contract, but I'll let you know that we're actively looking in the Austin area. And again, if you want it to come to your city, come talk to us, because really a big part what brings it to your city is the big local help that does the scouting and then helping with the negotiations and also getting set up and actually doing a lot of the heavy lifting here, as you've seen Steve, Tina, Phil, Kenny, Gary putting on for us. Okay, so we saw how many of you were here first, and we saw how many were from out of town, so this is really wonderful. We'll go ahead and start kicking off. As I mentioned, bathrooms are out there. As we're in the summit right now, Lily is the demo room, so we'll take time out later on today. Of course, at lunchtime, you can wander into the demo room. Demo room is open all day today, all day tomorrow. People are already setting up their demos in there. You're encouraged to bring your demos. You don't have to give a talk to give a demo. Tomorrow we'll have introductory sessions in Cedar 3, which is right to the direct. If you step out of here, it's toward the right. Now, the banquet, this is an older diagram. So the lunches, the Friday night social, and the banquet are actually downstairs in the Tamarack Hall. So all four of those activities are downstairs. All right, I think that's about it. So any quick questions before we kick off the first talk? All right, now I should say I'm hanging onto a wireless mic here. What we like to do for the videotaping is, of course, the presenter is going to be up here at the podium presenting. And when it comes time to question time, when you have a question, please raise your hand. And what we'd like to do is hand you this wireless mic, let you ask your question so it gets onto the video. Okay? So give us time to get it out to you. We only have the one mic here for this, for the show. All right. With that, let's bring John Hayes on up and we'll get started.